someone asked me to describe my style, I thought for a moment and said, class with a bit of sass, but never trash. My early 20s, I got on the international best dress list, and I was the youngest one to be on there. I have an adventurous spirit. I received my black belt first degree in Taekwondo when I was 60 years old. When I had to take the test and everything, and I got through it, I started crying. It was because it was hard, but it was fabulous. The day before my 79th birthday, I parachuted out of a plane from 17,000 feet. Next. And when I came home and told my husband, he said, what? He was so furious with me. He didn't know what to say. He said, you have four boys. I said, well, you know, I'm adventurous. I was fine. I learned about fashion, and I wanted to ask my daddy in the summer if I could make some money. So I said that we had a teen department, and I said, I want to make some money, so can I work, you know, at the store? And so daddy said, yes, absolutely. So this girl comes in, and with her mother, and she, you know, pick out clothes and everything for school. And she said, oh, Lynn, you've been so, they didn't know my last name, so they didn't know I was, you know, oh, Lynn, you've been so nice to us. Tell us what you can do. I said, just tell everybody to come to up when they come to the store to ask for Lynn. I never said my last name. I was very fortunate to have met and entertained presidents, movie stars, royalty, prince and princesses, and each in their own individual way, are still friends of mine, and they're very special in my life. Friends are friends no matter what, whether they're famous or not. My friends are precious to me. I could name whole pages of them, but I hate name droppers. We got along like a house on fire. I mean, the first minute we met each other, we just kept talking and talking and talking. And then she said, I want to invite you to the palace. And I had the best time. I had the best time. But I said to her, sitting across the table, I said, Grace, you know, I love you because I know your inside. I know you're how you are, you know. But I want to tell you something. I'm looking at you like somebody else would look at you. And here you have this hat on, and I don't see any hair in it. Your face is so beautiful that I just have to tell you that. And she said, oh, poo, Lynn. Oh, poo. Get over it. Truman Capote was such a good friend, and I would be with him every time I went to New York. He was hysterical, and he has this high-pitched voice, and when he talked over television or wherever, people would laugh. But then he was so smart that they were just mesmerized by hearing him talk. And so I went to one of her shows, and she sent somebody out to take me backstage to see her. And she said, Lynn, I know who you are, and I'm so happy you're here. I said, well, I sure as heck know you who you are. You were fabulous. You're just meant to be on the stage. I was with Tony Bennett and George Hamilton. So I had two gorgeous guys on the other side of me. When I went to see his home, he took me upstairs, and by his bed were all these books. And I said, are you reading this book? He said, I read every night. I read every night. But I don't want to get out of bed to get the book, so I have the books there. He asked me, what is the difference between a Texas woman and any other woman? We Texas gals think we can do anything that we set our minds to, and we do it. Yay, Texas girls. I think, in fact, I know the most wonderful thing is that happened to me is having my four boys. We are so close. I call my husband Oscar my protector since 58 years of marriage. And I always tease him and said, and I haven't killed you yet, so watch your back. We were flying, and he was piloting, and I was next to him. And I said, honey, you know, you've never really proposed to me. And he said, well, I'm not going to propose to you. And I said, why not? He said, because you're going to propose to me. I said, I put my hands on my hips. I said, I am not. Yes, you are. I am not. Yes, you are. You want to make a bet? I said, yes. I'll bet you $1 million that I'm not. That you're going to propose to me. He said, okay, you better shake on it. So we shake hands, and he's flying, and we go about maybe 10 minutes silent. He said, all right, are you going to propose to me or not? And I said, no, you're going to propose to me. He said, okay, remember what you said. Remember what you said. He puts the plane in a dive. I mean, not like down like that, but it starts going down. And I could take off my seatbelt and put on my knees. And I said, will you marry me? Will you marry me? Yes. As she goes up in the plane. I became involved in the Star of Hope when they called me to tell me that they had 6 Christmas trees and they wanted me to choose the best Christmas tree, which will make the most money. I said, well, I would like to come out and see your facilities before I put my name on something. And so they said, Lynn Wyatt's gonna come up and light the Christmas tree. So I walk up there and I said, you know, I was here this afternoon and I tried to put on the Christmas tree lights and they wouldn't go on for me. Is it broken or what? I said, you know, I want all the children to come and sit around the Christmas tree and count from 10 to 1 and you'll make the Christmas tree lights go on. And so 3, 2, 1, and click. I had a little click there. Click. Oh, I said, look what you did. You made the lights go on. You made the lights. I've been with them every year since. It sounds so corny, but I am thankful and grateful for everything that has happened to me. Really. So thank you, Lord.